William Lloyd Garrison, an abolitionist, was a man who led many to realize the truth about slavery. An abolitionist is a person who wants to abolish slavery. But nowhere in his life did Garrison have any tragedy that had to do with slavery. So how did Garrison become such a profound abolitionist? William Lloyd Garrison was born December 10, 1805, in Newburyport, Massachusetts, to Francis Maria Lloyd and Abijah Garrison. Unfortunately, during his childhood, Garrison's father could not secure a job and turned to drinking. He later abandoned the family. The family was forced to beg for leftovers from rich people. When Garrison turned 7, he was placed in the service of Deacon Ezekiel Bartlett. While there, he tended to their house chores while his family moved to Lynn, Massachusetts. These 2 years were the closest to normal life Garrison had in his childhood. In 1814, Garrison's mother brought him to Lynn, Massachusetts and had him apprenticed to a shoemaker. A year later, his family moved to Baltimore, Maryland, and started working in a shoe factory. Garrison later moved back to the Bartletts and was briefly and unsuccessfully apprenticed to a cabinet maker. After this, he began apprentice to Ephraim Allen, the editor of the Newburyport Herald. While apprentice to Allen, Garrison wrote a column for the Newburyport Herald. In one of these columns was Garrison's first reference to slavery. His apprenticeship to Allen ended in December of 1825. In 1826, Garrison became the editor of the Free Press, a local paper. Within a few months, Garrison obtained the position of publisher, but the paper was sold before the year ended. He then, looking for work, went to Boston and met Nathaniel Witt. Together, they became the editors of the National Philanthropist. In the spring of 1828, Garrison had complete control over the editorial policy. While in the city, he met Lyman Beecher and Benjamin Lundy, two men who were abolitionists. On July 4, 1829, Garrison delivered his first public speech against slavery. Garrison first believed in gradual emancipation of slaves, but after meeting Lyman Beecher and Benjamin Lundy, he changed his mind and wanted immediate emancipation of slaves. This belief dominated Garrison's life for the next 3 decades. Afterwards, Garrison returned to Baltimore and wrote editorial columns for the Genius of Universal Emancipation. He was later sued for and found guilty of libel or false publication that defames a live person. He was unable to pay the fine and was sent to jail for 7 weeks. Upon release, Garrison left the Genius of Universal Emancipation and began lecturing in East Coast cities throughout the summer of 1830. While lecturing, Garrison came up with the idea to start his own anti-slavery journal. The Liberator was first published in Boston on July 1, 1831. Because there was never more than 3,000 copies sold at a time, The Liberator stood on the thin edge of insecurity. The Liberator produced very little action from the earlier issues. Although Garrison sought for the emancipation of slaves to be peaceful, he intended to provoke others. Governor Floyd of Virginia blamed Garrison for the uprising led by black preacher Nat Turner. After having threat mail sent to him, Garrison stated, "Nothing but my own death or want for financial support shall stop the Liberator." Realizing the need for a local anti-slavery group, Garrison founded the New England Anti-Slavery Society, or NEAS, in Boston in January of 1832, with the Liberator as his official publication. He also assisted in the formation of the American Anti-Slavery Society in Philadelphia in the December of 1833. While traveling, Garrison met Miss Helen Benson from Brooklyn, Connecticut. They married September 4, 1834, and rented a house in Roxbury, Massachusetts. They have 7 children, but only 5 survived past infancy. In October of 1835, Garrison went to a meeting of the Boston Female Anti-Slavery Society. There, he became the target of a mob that originally wanted to tar and feather Speaker George Thompson, an English abolitionist. Without the help of Boston Mayor Theodore Lyman, Garrison would not have escaped the mob. For his own safety, Garrison was arrested and held in a jail cell overnight. Garrison's health started to deteriorate in early 1840. He frequently suffered from headaches and exhaustion. Despite his weak stature, Garrison continued to make weekly appeals through the Liberator for a peaceful separation of the North from the South. From 1840 to 1861, the motto of the journal was, "No union with slaveholders." During 1847, Garrison undertook a tour of the Alleghenies with Frederick Douglass to speak out about slavery. In a time of only 26 days, Garrison spoke more than 40 times to crowds. The pace at which he was lecturing people and the foul weather also had bad effects on his lungs. From 1847 to 1850, Garrison had to spend considerable time at home because of his lung problems. When the South finally seceded from the Union, Garrison was residing in the White Mountains recovering from his lung problems. After the Emancipation Proclamation, Garrison proposed for the dissolution of the American Anti-Slavery Society. It is rejected because people believe that freedom is just the beginning, not the end, of abolition. The last issue of The Liberator was published on December 29th, 1865, 3 days from the 34th anniversary of The Liberator. This was finally when Garrison's life as an abolitionist and as a public figure ended. William Lloyd Garrison died in his daughter's home in New York City on May 24th, 1879, and was buried 4 days later on the family plot in Roxbury.